Hi, welcome to our channel. Okay, I hope that you remembered yesterday we discussed that what is meant by the light and what are the properties of the light. I hope you remembered. And next I told one important thing to you, when the light is going to fall on the one surface, how many phenomena are going to occur? 3 phenomena are going to occur. In that, what are the phenomena? I hope you remember. I am drawing simple small diagram. This is the object. When the light is falling on the surface, this is going to get the reflection. Second one is getting in the same medium, getting back some amount of the light is absorbed. Second thing is some amount of the light is transmitted. So now I given the one formula is total energy equal to R plus T plus A RTA. I have given in the previous class. So now absorption is not there in our syllabus. I told to you we are going to discuss about the reflection. Is it clear? So now just I am going to give little bit introduction about the reflection. Then again I will come to our syllabus. Reflection on different surfaces. Very nice topic, that is reflection on the spherical surface. Why I am going to say like that means, when I hope that when you go to the different shops, for example, I am going to say, I hope you, maybe it is experienced to girls. They know that when they go to the beauty parlor, for example, eyebrows, they want to remove some hair. If they see in the normal mirror, how much is the eyebrow, is there same amount only they are going to get? Extra hair removing becomes difficult. That's why when they sit in front of one mirror, I won't say the name now, afterwards we are going to discuss, when they sit in front of the one mirror, this much of small eyebrow become this much of small, bigger size, then extra hair they are going to remove very easily, becomes they are visible very clearly. So this all, second thing is, when we go on the bike, we can see wide area. For example, means to see the mirror is this much only, but it is going to cover this much of total road. So how it is happening? Second thing is our dish. See here, why the dish is in the shape of concave, that is called concave. I will say why we have given the name is the concave also. I will tell very easy words I will mix up, and today I came with good jokes. I will entertain also you. Okay, so let's start the lesson. That is, see here, now I am going to write here what is meant by the reflection. Writing reflection. See here, Nana. When light is going to fall on any surface means I am going to say any object surface. For example, I am going to take one surface, it is the wooden surface. Otherwise, I am going to say our book surface. Like that, any surface you can take. When the light is going to falls on this surface, light is falling on this surface means, for example, see, I am going to draw the ray is like this. Here I am going to draw the arrow. What this arrow is going to represent? This arrow represents that light ray is traveling in this direction. Which light ray going to falls on the one surface? This ray is called incident ray. Incident means falling. Incident ray. Otherwise, simply we are going to use IR. IR means incident ray. Now I am going to say this ray is falling on this surface. If it is going to fall on the surface, I am going to reveal that this surface is opaque material. Opaque material means what is going to happen? Maximum amount of the light is going to falling on the surface and rebouncing. Rebouncing means coming and going in the same, the air in the same plane, it is moving in backward direction. This phenomena is called refraction. Is it clear? So I am going to make the one sentence here. For the definition, I am going to write here. When a light ray falls on a surface, this surface should be what? Opaque. When a light ray falls on a surface, it rebounds back. Rebounds back in same plane. This phenomena is called reflection of light. Please write very, very fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Otherwise, pause the video and write it. I am going to rub this one. See here. Next thing is, incident ray fell on this one. Sir, after falling on the surface, it is going like this in the same plane. Same plane means we have to understand. What is meant by plane? For example, mathematically you know that. I am going to draw the one graph paper like this. This is called x, x dash. This is the y, y dash. If the ray is coming from here, it will go this side. If the ray is coming from here, it will go this side. Like this only it is happens. Because if I am going to take, this is the reflecting surface. If it is coming like this, it is go like this only. If it is coming from the x dash, y dash, it will go x, y dash. So plane is same plane. Here x y dash is called reflecting plane. Y dash x is called incident plane. Incident plane means the incident ray belongs to which plane? That is called incident plane. And reflected ray is coming from which plane? That is called reflected plane. Both are belongs to whom? X, y. If tomorrow examination the question will give like this, incident ray is coming from y z plane, then reflected ray will go by which plane? Don't get confusion. Coming from the YZ, then automatically it will go by which plane? YZ only. Is that clear to you? So now when it is going to get the reflection, what are the rules it is going to follow? That rules we have to discuss. If we know that rules, easy to understand much more. Light we can understand very well and easy also. I hope that you retain this one. I am going to rubbing. See, when the light is going to falls on the one surface, in surface, when I'm going to use, again I'm repeating this term, surface, when I'm going to say, what is actually meant by the one surface or means, which separates the two medium, otherwise two material. Means once observe there, this is the surface, below the surface, air is there. Above the surface, air is there. This is what? Surface. So now surface is one material. It is one material. It is another material. It is another material. So like that, which is separating the medium? That is called surface. Which light is falling on the surface? That incident ray. Second thing is, I am going to classify this surface into two types. What are they means? Very, very smooth surface. Very, very smooth surface means, may you are thinking that like your face. Sir, I applied fair and lovely, I applied handsome and powder also I applied, that's why very, very smooth. That is not called here smooth surface. That is a fancy here. If, for example, try to understand here, generally when I am going to say reflector means best example, best thing comes to your mind is, sir, mirror. When the light comes and falls on the mirror, 100% means maximum percent it is going to get the reflection. So due to that only, when you are going to stand in front of the mirror, light rays coming from your face, falling on the mirror, again coming back. That's why you are able to see your face. Then I am asking the question to you, is your face is 100% reflector? Yes, but it is not 100% smooth. Why? How can we identify the smooth surfaces? Means, if the surface is very smooth, 100% smooth, it is going to give image. Why it will give the image, I will say to you. So now, if imagine that the surface is very, very 100% smooth surface. That's why generally I am going to use the smooth and rough surface is there now. I am using here optically smooth. Optically smooth means according to the light, very, very fine smooth. Our smoothness means our wall is smooth. This is called mechanical smooth. It's clear to you. So now the light, otherwise easy to understand, I have taken the mirror. Means one glass sheet, very smooth is there. In the one side I have done with silver coating to become the good reflector. Metals are good reflectors, you know very well. So now the ray is falling on the surface. So which ray is falling on the surface? This is called what, Nana? Incident ray. Why should I write total? Already we learnt incident ray means I am writing IR. Clear? Second thing is, at which location it is falling, that location, so many names we are going to give. So many means what? Is it, this is what? Incident ray. At the which location incident ray is falling, this name, the point name I have given, this name is incident point. Clear? What is meant by incident point? On the surface, at which location light ray is falling, that point is called incident point. Second thing is, after falling at this location, light is moving in the same plane like this, means it is moving in opposite like this. Now once please tell to me, what you are going to give name for this one? Sir, it is rebounced, reflected. Then we are going to give the name is what? Reflected ray. Otherwise, RR. IR, RR. Is that clear? So now, what is this? Normal. Normal means 90 degrees width. I told you, na, X, Y, Z graph paper I want to divide. That's why only now I have taken one normal. Now, when you are going to measures or you are going to give the names, I am going to give the name is, you told what, Nana? Incident point. But our friend is there, na? He is telling like that, sir, why I am going to use the incident point, sir? If I am not seeing from this side, he is seeing from this side. Our friends are like that only, na? When we say the one thing, he will take in opposite way. So now, when you see from this side, he was telling that, sir, from here only this reflected ray came. That's why he is going to give the name is reflected point. From this side, if you see, this is called incident point. Same point from here I am going to give the name is reflected point. So now I am going to ask the question to you. Incident point and reflected point, both are same or different? Very good. Both are same. So now this name I am going to give, any one name your wish, I am going to give the name is the O. So if I give here one name is the A, here name is the B. Please, I am going to ask the question to you. Give answer for me. In the given diagram, what is the reflected point, reflection point? वो वेरी गुड. विच रे इज कॉल्ड, वाट इज द नेम ऑफ द रे ऑफ इंसिडेंट. ओ ए वेरी गुड. रिफ्लेक्टेड रे इज वाट, वो बी. वेरी क्लियर. सो विच सरफेस इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग, मिरर. वाट एवर यू हैव टेकन द सरफेस, ऑन विच सरफेस लाइट इज गेटिंग द रिबाउंड, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस. इज दैट क्लियर. सो दिस इज द रिफ्लेक्शन फिनोमेना. लिटिल बिट I'm going to ask one depth question. Incident ray and reflected ray both belongs to same plane or not? बोलिए बोलिए बोलिए. Very good. See there, sir, if I'm going to take this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. X and y is the plane for whom? Incident ray. And this is the negative x, mean this is a positive x, then this is the y. So now plus or minus, that is for our convenience we made directions, but anyhow x and y plane only now. So now reflected ray also belongs to same plane. Is it clear? So now incident ray and reflected ray both are belongs to xy plane. So now this is called first rule of reflection. Please write there, Nana. What is the first rule of reflection? Incident ray and reflected ray both belongs to first rule. Incident ray and reflected ray both belongs to same plane. This is called first rule of reflection. Clear? I hope that you understood first rule of reflection. Next, once you see there, I am going to ask that this is the x, y or normal, and here some angle is making one subject. This in the angle is name is what? You know. Very good. That is called the angle between the normal to the incident is called incident angle. Incident angle is represented by small I. After the second thing I am going to say, the angle between the reflected ray and normal, this angle is called reflected angle, represented by small r. What is meant by incident angle? Angle between normal to incident ray. This is the normal, this is the incident. This angle is there here, this angle is called incident angle. After reflection, angle between the normal to the reflected ray, that angle is called reflected angle. This much studied after also in examination. Tomorrow he will give one question to you like this. This is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray. He will give here. Please identify the incident angle. When he is going to ask, represent or identify the incident angle, means our friends are going to draw the diagram, re-diagram like this innocently. Sir, you know incident angle is this, sir. Is it correct? No. So please remember, incident angle means with vertical. Vertical means sunlight is always coming from the sun, na? That's why we are going to take represented line or reference line is the y-axis. So now with this normal, how much angle is making? This is called I. This is the correct, this is the wrong. Same way, the reflected angle means this is the R, this is not called R. Clear to you? So now I am going to ask one question. Please, can you give answer for me? Okay. I hope that you are sitting with copy only. Write the one question, Nana. Fast. Writing? Okay. This is the given graph. This is the given graph. Identify reflected ray give one name. Give one name means you have to represent with some alphabets. Okay, how you are going to identify? Which arrow mark is showing? This arrow mark is showing downward means coming. Coming ray is called what? Incident. Going ray is called what? Reflected. Then you are going to say, this is the reflected ray, sir. The name I am giving, this is the O, this is the B, this is the A. Any name you can give. Your name letters also you can give. R, A, S. A, S is reflected ray. Is that clear to you? So, I hope that you understood this phenomena also. Now here the light is going to follow another one rule I told you now. So now that rule is what, Nana? Always incident angle equals to reflected angle. Angle I equal to angle R. Always. Why I am writing always? Maximum you have that doubt. Sir, if the surface is plane only, I equals to R. If the surface is not plane, sir, if the plane surface is like this rough, then if the light ray is coming like this, how you are going to prove I equal to R? In this case also, it is going to follow the rule I equals to R. This type of surfaces are called irregular, means rough surface. Here how we are going to prove means, now it will take lengthy time, Nana, in when you want for IIT classes, when I will come to the IIT classes, that is a separate class we are going to start. In that one we will go very deep. Okay, so now these two are called laws of the reflection. So clear? So now I am going to rub it. So now please, if you didn't write fast, write very fast. So next I am going to do reflection by spherical surface. But we need to discuss what is meant by spherical surface. So now see here, I am going to write here spherical surface. Spherical surface means what? And how we are going to make spherical shape mirrors? Mirrors means what, Nana? Which give the reflection of light. So now you have to understand what is meant by the spherical surface means. I am going to give simply one word answer. If any surface is having the curvature. Curvature means it is like the curved surface. So now if it is having the curved surface, then we are going to say that is the spherical surface. Otherwise I am going to say a part of the hollow sphere is a spherical surface. May if you listen this word little bit, you will get the inconvenience. I will explain very easy word. Imagine karo, I hope that you have seen the football. Very good. So now I am going to take the one football. Football inside is what is there? Nothing is there. It is the hell. Nothing means air is there. That is not considered. So now it is having the one layer, thick layer. So now I am going to draw. If I am going to draw, the football is like this. Clear? Very good. Inside air is there. Football, if you see like that, what I am going to do? If you are going to cut this football into two, I hope in mathematics also you know it, they are called hemisphere. If you are going to make the two parts, one part you are going to get the like the one bowl. Clear? Very good. But I don't want this much of bigger size. What I have done, I have taken one chaku, going to break this is small part I am going to make. If you are going to see from the top, If you are going to see from the top, may you are able to see like this. Correct or not? You are able to see like this. If you see from the side wide, you are going to see the same thing like this. Now once observe there. It is having how many surfaces? Two surfaces. What are they, sir? One surface is, one see there, this is the surface. It is curved surface or not? Curved surface. It is taken from sphere. That's why I told to you this surface is called what? Spherical surface. And if you are going to see from this side, this is curved inside, bulged not out, it is bulged inside. And if you see from this side, when you coming this direction and if you are going to see, this curved surface came out. That's why here it is having the two surfaces. What are they? One is the curved inside, sir. One is the curved outside, sir. Then we have to give the names. How I am going to give the names means, please try to understand. When you are going to see like this, here inside surface I am writing. Inside surface. Inside surface, what is the name do you like to give? Achcha se dekho, manchiga chudandi. Answer cheppagalaru. See, when you see from here, it is like cave. Cave means in our Telugu, guha. Ante, manam guha lopariki pothunna oka feeling ledu. Ante itla, it is in the shape of the cave. So that's why we have given the name is, this is the surface is concave. Con means it is from the curvature. Cave means it is the shape of the cave. Guha laga undi. That's why this surface, inside surface given what? Concave. Concave opposite, I am going to give the outside surface is convex. So, I hope now you understood that. Here, what is meant by the spherical surface and how we have given the names means, we have given the names is, this is the concave, this side is the convex. And what are the terminology belongs to these spherical surfaces? Much more terminology is there. We are going to discuss tomorrow. I hope you understood about the reflection and about the spherical surface. Thank you. Thank you very, very much for watching.